Mustangs, welcome to Press Pass, SMU's Spotlight on Sports. I'm Grace Lawrence.
And I'm Martha Mills. Let's go. SMU football won against the Memphis Tigers for the first time since 2013 last Saturday. It was a close game, but the Mustangs came out on top with a score of 30-27. Last weekend's game puts the Mustangs at a record of 4-0 for a second straight season. SMU is the first team in the nation to reach a record of 4-0 this season.
SMU quarterback Shane Buechele continues to rack up accolades for his play. The grad transfer senior was named the Davey O'Brien National Quarterback of the Week following the win over Memphis. Buechele passed for a career-high 474 yards and found the end zone three times. The career day for Buechele also earned him the American Athletic Conference Offensive Player of the Week award. After their win against Memphis, SMU football had a bye over the weekend. The team will now be heading to New Orleans to take on Tulane on Friday night. The Mustangs have moved up one spot in the AP poll top 25 rankings to number 17, making them the second highest ranked team in Texas behind Texas A&M. You can catch the Shane Buechele and the Mustangs at 5 p.m. on ESPN.
As the SMU football season continues on, so do changes to student fan experience. These differences and how they impact fans on the Hilltop. SMU TV's Grace Lawrence joins us to tell us more.
College football is more than a game. It's an experience for all college students. But these past 2 years, students have had to adapt to a new way of enjoying the game. SMU students know change well, especially when it comes to Mustangs football.
When I came here my freshman year, I was really expecting the kind of boulevard experience that was advertised, when I was looking at SMU senior year, and it totally changed.
Boulevarding is a term SMU uses for its tailgating, and it's something SMU prides itself on. Traditionally, the front of Dallas Hall lawn, although emptied this season, is dedicated to fans like alumni and season ticket holders, and the back half was dedicated to the students.
And honestly, I think it's a big reason a lot of people like coming to SMU, because it's a tradition that we've all been a part of. And then all the alumni are there too. So my freshman year, coming in and having that right off the bat was something really fun that we got to do with all our new friends.
But that changed in 2019. SMU Athletics moved the Student Boulevard from the Dallas Hall lawn to Doak Walker Plaza.
So weird. Like, I went to the first one just to see what it was, and it was so hot, and it was on the concrete, and it was just different, and no one really went after the first one.
And when the Mustangs started winning, students started showing up. But seating has become an issue, along with COVID-19.
So during normal times, we normally all go to the grass, but this year everyone was there because there's no dedicated student section, because the cheerleaders and the band, they were all sitting where we normally sit in the bleachers.
Due to social distancing and mask rules, the student section was asked to leave during halftime of this year's game against Memphis.
So SMU security just started pushing me and my friends off the half of the lawn that we were on, which was really disappointing because once we left, there was no re-entry, so we couldn't get back in.
Disappointing during a season that's been anything but for the football team. Football looks to continue another successful season, and the students are all in as well. For SMU TV, I'm Grace Lawrence.
With college football in full swing, NCAA conferences are putting plans together for college basketball, including the American Athletic Conference. Commissioner Mike Oresko announced that conference play will happen in a 20-game double round-robin style for both men and women starting December 14th. For the first time ever, the AAC Conference Championship for both men and women will both take place in the same city and venue, Fort Worth's Dickey Stadium, during mid-March. Among the many SMU sports making a return to campus this fall in the midst of the coronavirus is SMU's women's tennis. They ended their season abruptly during mid-March and are now training in preparation for their spring season in 2021. Things look a lot different too. They have to wear masks when they aren't physically practicing and remain 6 feet apart throughout the entire practice. Despite the differences, COVID-19 has given this team, they are excited to be back and able to play with their teammates.
It's been so fun. Everyone has been obviously distant, but back together. It's been super loud, super energetic. And I just think we can feel the energy of everyone just being really excited and ready to get like back to season and get back to playing matches again.
For more information about the women's tennis team, visit www.smumustangs.com and click on the Women's Tennis tab. After the break, find out how former Mustangs are performing in the pros. Plus, one man went all out on his team decorations. Stay with us.
A country western stunt dance team, so it's line dancing and swing dance, but there's a lot of acrobatic stunts in there, so flips and learning how to safely be thrown around and stuff, so that's what we do. I wasn't really sure about the whole country western dance aspect of it, but once I got to know like this amazing team, I was like, yep, nope, this is where I want to be.
I didn't think Mustang Mavericks would be the group I'm most involved in my undergraduate career. It ended up being like my second family here.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. For more information on Mustang Mavericks, visit smumustangmaverick.wixsite.com/ponyup.
All across the sports world, former Mustang athletes are getting recognized for their play. SMU TV's Will Daughton has the highlights.
Hey Mustangs, this is SMU TV's Will Daughton here with your ponies in the pros. We'll start this week on the golf course, where former SMU standout Bryson DeChambeau has been turning heads with both his play and physique. The 2015 NCAA champion has put on nearly 40 pounds of muscle this year to increase his driving distance. Since PGA Tour competition returned in June, DeChambeau has put together some stellar performances, winning the Rocket Mortgage Classic and capturing his first major title at the U.S. Open in September. This past week, DeChambeau continued his strong play at the Shriners Hospitals for Children Open, where he finished tied for 8th place. We will keep an eye on his performance at the Masters Tournament in November to see if his tactics continue to pay off. On the soccer pitch, former SMU star Eddie Munjoma has been bringing the energy in his first professional matches. The former All-American signed with the FC Dallas organization in January. He suited up for his first game earlier this month with North Texas SC, the United Soccer League affiliate of FC Dallas. On Saturday, Munjoma scored his first professional goal at the end of the first half to give North Texas a 2-0 lead over the Richmond Kickers. Munjoma will look to build on his performance in the team's next game against New England on Friday. Coming to the NFL, New Orleans Saints wide receiver Emmanuel Sanders had his best performance of the season so far on Monday Night Football. He finished with a career-high 12 receptions for 122 yards as he helped the Saints secure an overtime victory over the Los Angeles Chargers. Sanders has shown a growing rapport with quarterback Drew Brees and will look to continue producing in Week 7 after the team's bye week. Former Mustangs throughout the sports world continue to represent the Hilltop with pride. This has been Will Daughton with your Ponies in the Pros.
Thanks, Will, for that report on the Ponies in the Pros. On Sunday, while former Mustangs were playing, so were the Dallas Cowboys. They faced off against the New York Giants Sunday afternoon in a close game that was decided by a field goal in the last seconds of the game. The Cowboys topped their divisional foes 37-34. Although the Cowboys won on the field, they suffered a devastating loss with the injury of starting quarterback Dak Prescott. Prescott was carted off the field during the second half with a compound fracture and ankle dislocation. The quarterback underwent a successful surgery Sunday night and was released from the hospital on Tuesday, but no information has been released yet on when he will be able to play again. The NBA season came to an end on Sunday night with the crowning of a new champion. Grace Lawrence has more on Full Court Press.
Hi Mustangs, welcome back to Full Court Press. The Lakers took home the championship against the Miami Heat, winning the final series 4-2. This one is very special to the Lakers. It comes after a season tributed to the late Laker legend Kobe Bryant and daughter Gigi, who passed away in a helicopter accident in March. Now, although Los Angeles was the favorite, Jimmy Butler and the Miami Heat gave them a serious run for their money. But nothing could stop LeBron James from getting his, quote, the respect he deserved with his fourth ring and finals MVP. He averaged 29.8 points, 11.8 rebounds, and 8.5 assists per game. He could not clinch this title alone, though. Teammate Anthony Davis proved why he is becoming the best big man in the game with dominant performances in both the paint and beyond the arc. Now, Texas native Alex Caruso worked his way to starting the final game as he became the spark the Lakers needed. And veteran Rajon Rondo became the only player to ever win a ring on both the Lakers and their rival team, the Celtics. What amazing accolade that came from this win was Jeannie Buss being the first female owner to win an NBA championship. The Lakers returned to Los Angeles with the hardware and look forward to celebrating with their city once it becomes more safe. Now the draft and free agency is about to begin, and we'll have everything you need to know about that next time. For SMU TV, I'm Grace Lawrence.
Thanks, Grace. The NHL season might be over, but hockey fans have already seen a busy start to the offseason. It's time now for NHL Power Play with Peter Warner.
Hey, y'all. This is SMU TV's Peter Warner skating at you with NHL Power Play. The NHL draft was last week. The New York Rangers' first pick was an easy choice, winger Alexis Lafreniere. New York got an absolute stud who scored 112 points in 52 games this year. Many have compared him to Sidney Crosby and Patrick Kane. The Kings took center Quinton Byfield with the second pick. Ottawa had two top five picks this year, taking center Tim Stützle with the third pick, which they acquired from the Sharks. With the fifth pick, they selected defenseman Jake Sanderson. Some big trades went down this week. The Wild dealt Devin Dubnyk and a 2022 seventh rounder to the Sharks for a 2022 fifth rounder. Ottawa got a new starter in net by trading for Matt Murray, sending Jonathan Gruden and a second rounder in return to Pittsburgh. Chicago traded winger Brandon Saad and Gilbert to the Lance for D-man Nikita Zadorov and Antoine Lindholm. This next trade brings us into some of the big names in free agency. Vegas cleared cap space by trading Paul Stastny to the Jets for Dahlstrom and a conditional fourth round pick in 2022. This trade allowed the Knights the space to sign star Alex Pietrangelo to a 7-year, $61 million deal. Taylor Hall is heading to Buffalo for 1 year at $8 million. Lundqvist moved on from New York after being with them for 15 years. The Kings signed a 1-year deal worth $1.5 million with the Caps. Torrey Krug signed with the Blues, 6 years at $6.5 annually. Khudobin will stay in Dallas for $3.3 a year for the next three seasons. Other big signings are Toffoli with the Habs, Smith with the Bruins, Brody to the Leafs, and Shattenkirk with the Ducks. That is it for this week's NHL Power Play. We are now back to even strength. This is Peter Warner with SMU TV.
Thanks, Peter, for that report. After the break, find out how this football fan is lighting up his community.
The tryouts is really the first couple of weeks of training. Come out, if you can make it, then you make the team.
We try and get everybody in, just because it's such an active sport. There's so much hitting, all that, just to get people who need rest, you know, get them off the bench, give everybody experiences like that.
We're really friendly out here. We need more people. And you're just going to feel like a brotherhood and feel like a family if you come out with us.
If you decide this is something you want to do, then you can play rugby at SMU.
For more information, please visit facebook.com/SMU Rugby Club.
Chris Gann of Independence, Missouri is bringing some light to 2020 in a very special way. Every Saturday night, the homeowner puts a Kansas City Chiefs-themed light show in front of his house. Gant's yard houses over 140,000 lights, and he said his electricity bill is about $100 more with his display.
The display seems fitting for the NFL team coming off a championship season, who also has had a great start to the 2020 regular season with a record of 4-1.
You know, this is a great way to start getting into the holiday spirit. Well, that's all we have for you, Mustangs. Be sure to check out our Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram for the latest on SMU sports.
And as always, be sure to keep up with your Hilltop sports by checking out smudailycampus.com. You can catch Press Pass and other SMU TV shows on Channel 9 on University Park Cable. That does it for this week's edition of Press Pass. Thanks for tuning in. Be sure to tune in next time for all the latest happenings in SMU sports.
We'll see you back here October 28th. Pony up, Mustangs.